We still got it, you know? We still write good songs, and maybe we'll be that band that puts out that great record later in their career.
She walks in so many ways. She wanders alone in the shade. She shakes.
For the Jayhawks, it's really about the song, and it's about the Mark and Gary vocal. '85, Minneapolis is kind of a tight scene, you know, rock scene, and everybody kind of knew each other, and Mark and I had both been in competing rockabilly bands at the time, but so we kind of knew each other, and I remember running into him at the Embers, this coffee shop, and he said, come down to the Uptown Bar, my new band's playing. So I showed up, but I showed up right when they were getting off stage. He said, our guitar player just quit, do you know anybody you'd like to play? And they were looking at me, and I got the message, so I joined the band.
We would play at this bar called the 400 Bar. That was where we really got it together because we had to play three sets a night. And I feel like that was the real time when we really formed a band that was gonna do something.
After that first record, we just kind of found our own sound. It's always been easy, we work really fast. I mean, we work hard, but that's just the way we've always worked. It just happens.
It's got a pace, of kind of a hectic, manic pace, gonzo kind of pace.
Yeah.
I'll tell now how I wanted to get off the why and how I got off the
merry-go-round.
The grand merry-go-round. We'll turn down the violins slightly. No, I was in the band for about 13 years and had worked super hard. It had been my whole life, you know, basically had lived in so many different apartments and slept on so many different couches, but that hadn't mattered. We went out to California, and we toured super hard, went over to Europe on both the records. And at the end of that second record, I just felt like at that time that I'd done everything I could, that I was exhausted. I probably should have taken a break, like a nice 3, 4, 6 month break, but I tend to be all drama and things of that nature, so
I would have. There's no halfway with Mark, it's full on.
It's 100% and that's how I do things. And actually Gary and I started to get back together in a way in 2001. It's taken us a little long to actually make this final step as far as going back into the Jayhawks.
And I think another factor really was finding out our keyboard player, Karen Grotberg, was open to touring again, and she was always fit in so well with us and it balanced our personalities out and that. Just made it.
She's
all
the most Minnesotan of us all.
We just made a new album in November. We made it in Minneapolis, and there's Mark Perlman on bass and Tim O'Regan on drums, Karen Grotberg on keyboards, and Mark and myself singing and playing guitars. And Mark and I had numerous sessions, and you know, we just kept getting together and trying to make sure we had the best songs we could. But when I listen to our songs from the past, I feel like we're kind of old souls, you know, back then too. Our songs were not about, you know, necessarily going to the party, you know, and getting drunk and stuff. We were like singing,
yeah, trying to write timeless
traditional songs, you know,
sort of a mysterious, spiritual kind of way. So that's what it's always been about, and hopefully we have those type of songs again.
That's why I think like the new songs kind of fit in with the old songs, because I still think that it's not like we're a one-trick pony, but I think we certainly
developed a style.
Mm-hmm.
I was thinking of it in terms of like a hopeful look. It's somebody who has another chance in life. So that's she walks in so many ways, and that's for everybody concerned that, you know, there's different paths you can take.
Yeah, it's not really necessarily about one particular person or, you know, we're staying tight-lipped because I love when somebody comes up and says, that song, it's about this and this and this, and I'm like, I never thought about it that way, but you're exactly right. I mean, why not?
I like this Black Eyed Susan song because it's so psychedelic as far as like lyrics and music. I mean, it's just a total drama. The lead character, Black Eyed Susan, could be a drug addict, could be a person who has basically inflicted a lot of hurt on themselves and others. And so it's 4 in the morning. Everything's totally wrong, totally devastated, and this person's asking her, tell us what to do now, you know?
Tell us what to do, like I'd Susan.
I like this song called Tiny Arrows just because it's emotional and musical journey. We've got some really simple songs on the record, some straightforward songs, and then we have like four or five that are these multiple part, almost like chapters. And musically it just goes into it. Just when you think it's done, it goes to another part, you know. It's like my favorite part of the song, and it happens almost at the very end. It's just like second bridge, and you know, and then it's just slow.
Did you pull the old second bridge on that one?
We did the bridge A and bridge B.
Woo!
Our songs don't really necessarily always have verses and choruses. They have just multiple parts that somehow fit together. I assume that's good. It makes it more interesting to us.
The sunrise disappears.
We like to play, we like each other, and we still feel like we have a lot of music to make, and I don't think there's anything more enjoyable than being on stage. That, and it just seems like we mean something to people. You know, people come up to you after the show and say, yeah, you saved me when I was this, that, and that's the stuff that makes you feel like, oh, maybe I'm doing something important. So, here we are.
As you go, so I go. Where you stand, I will stand stronger than the world.